Now see the fifth question. The question is 5x square y minus 5x square plus 3yx square minus 3y square plus x square minus y square plus 8xy square minus 3y square. So what we have to do first? Find the like terms. 5x square y. So x square y term you have to find. Okay. This one and this one both are like terms, so that we have to write together. If you want, you can write this 3x square y. Then minus 5x square plus x square. So they are like terms. So 5 minus 5x square plus x square. So this is done. Then minus 3xy square minus y square, again minus 3y square. These three are like terms. So minus 3y square minus y square minus 3y square. Now what is left? Plus 8xy square. We don't have any other term, so this term remains as it is. So now we do the addition of these two terms. Now we directly do the addition because we know that variables remain same. So 5 plus 3 will give you 8. We do the addition of numerical coefficients. That is 5 plus 3 will give you 8. So variables are x square and y square. Minus 5x square plus x square. So minus 5 plus 1. Here the numerical coefficient is minus 5. Here the numerical coefficient is 1. So minus 5 plus 1 will give you minus 4. What is the variable? X square. Now we do the addition of this. Minus 3 minus 1 will give you minus 4. Minus 4 minus 3 will give you minus 7. So we are doing the addition of numerical value. Minus 3 minus 1 minus 3 will give you minus 7. What is the variable? Y square. And the last term remain as it is, that is plus 8xy square. So this way directly also we can solve the questions. So this is all about question number 5. Move on to the next question. Now see the 6th question. 3y square plus 5y minus 4 in one bracket minus in second bracket 8y minus y square minus 4. Which is equal to 3y square plus 5y minus 4. Open the brackets, sign will be changed. So minus 8y minus minus plus y square minus minus plus 4. So now we do find the like term first. So 3y square, y square, they are like terms. So 3y square plus y square, then plus 5y minus 8y. So plus 5y minus 8y, then minus 4 plus 4. So this way we have to first write all the like terms together. Now we do the addition or subtraction. So 3y square plus y square. So coefficient of y square is 3, here 1. So 3 plus 1 is 4y square. Now here plus 5 minus 8. Variables are same, that is y is the variable. So plus 5 minus 8. So which term is greater? 8. So what is the answer? Minus 8 minus 5 is 3y. So we always write the terms which is greater and whose sign is there. So minus sign, so minus 3. Okay. Minus 4 plus 4 will cancel each other. So you are getting only 0. So the answer is 4y square minus 3y. So this way we can solve question number 6. Here the question number 1 is completed. So what we have to do in general, we have to club or we have to first find the like terms. After finding the like term, we have to do either addition or subtraction. We have to take care the basically the negative sign. If it is outside the bracket, we have to change the sign of the terms which are in the bracket after opening the bracket. Or when you want to make the bracket, that time if the negative sign is, if you want to take outside, that time also we have to change the sign of the terms which you want to keep in the bracket. So this way we can solve the question number 1. Now we move on to the question number 2. Now see question number 2. Add the following. See the first question. If you observe the first question, the question is 3mn, -5mn, 8mn, -4mn. So here we have 4 monomials and we have to do the addition of these monomials. So if you observe all the terms, they all are like terms. Directly we can do the addition. 3mn minus 5mn plus 8mn minus 4mn. Now we just do the club of positive and then negative terms. So we know that 3 and 8 both are positive terms, so we like write that together. Minus 5 and minus 4 negative terms, so we write them together. Now we do the first, do the addition of these two terms. 3 plus 8 will give you 11mn. Minus 5mn, minus 4mn will give you minus 5, minus 4 will give you minus 9mn. So 11 minus 9 is what? 2mn. So this way we can do the addition of first question. Move on to the second question. Now see the second question. The question is t minus xz, 3tz minus z and the z minus t. So we arrange these terms in column wise and we do the addition or subtraction. So t minus 8tz then plus. Now we have 3tz. So t term is not given. So we leave this space and write here plus 3tz minus z. Plus we have z minus t. So minus t is given. So we write here minus t plus z. So plus z. So wherever you have blank space, write that 0. So that you will not make any mistakes. I will solve this question both the way. It's up to you which method you have to apply. Now we do the addition. So minus z plus z give you 0. Minus 8 plus 3, that is minus 5. What is the variable? Tz. So tz. T minus t will give you 0. So what is your answer? Minus 5tz. This is the method where you have to arrange the terms column wise. Okay, now we will see the another way of solving the same question. We know the answer is minus 5tz. Let's see. Same question. T minus 8tz, we have to do the addition. So make first term in bracket plus second term in bracket plus third term in bracket. In all the three brackets in between, we have to keep the addition sign. Now we open the bracket. So T minus 8tz plus 3tz minus z plus z minus t. Now we collect the like terms together. So t and minus t minus 8tz plus 3tz and minus z plus z. So t plus t minus t both will get cancelled. Minus z plus z both will get cancelled. So what is left? Minus 8z plus 3z. So minus 8 plus 3 will give you minus 5tz. Okay, this is a horizontal method, that is a vertical method. It's up to you which method you have to apply. If you want to do the column wise method, that also you can do. And if you want to do this method this way, both the way the answer is correct. It's up to you which method you have to apply. I prefer this method because here you have to make the bracket, keep the addition sign because we are doing addition, then open the bracket and easily you can do the addition and subtraction. In column wise method, you have to find out the blank space and there you have to keep 0 and then do the calculation. So little bit mistake can be possible to do in that kind of method. Okay, so this way you can solve question number 2. Move on to the third question. Now see the third question. So I prefer the bracket method, that is minus 7mn plus 5 plus 12mn plus 2 plus 9mn minus 8 plus minus 2mn minus 3. Okay, addition is mentioned, that's why I am keeping plus sign in between all the brackets. So now we open the brackets. So minus 7mn plus 5 plus 12mn plus 2 plus 9mn minus 8 plus minus minus 2mn plus minus minus 3. Now what we do? We find the like terms. Minus 7mn plus 12mn plus 9mn minus 2mn. So these are like terms, so we write like terms together. Minus 2mn. Now we have another terms, constant term, plus 5 plus 2 minus 8 minus 3. So plus 5 plus 2 minus 8 minus 3. Now we do the addition. Minus 7 plus 12 plus 9 minus 2. We do the addition of this. So minus 7 plus 12, what is your answer? 5. Plus 5. Plus 5 plus 9, 14. 14 minus 2, 12. So when you solve this, you are getting the answer 12mn. Next we have plus 5 plus 2 will give you 7. Minus 8 minus 3 will give you minus 11. 7 minus 11, what is the answer? Minus 4. So this way we can solve question number 3. Move on to the next question.